वेलकम एवरीवन। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज चैप्टर नंबर 5 अप्लाइंग फॉर्मेटिंग इफेक्ट्स। फॉर दैट यू हैव टू ओपन द माइक्रोसॉफ्ट पावर पॉइंट, क्लिक ऑन स्टार्ट बटन, ऑल प्रोग्राम, माइक्रोसॉफ्ट ऑफिस एंड देन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट पावर पॉइंट। बाई डिफॉल्ट दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट इंटरफेस वेयर यू गट द नॉर्मल व्यू to work upon. Today we are going to learn about the slide master. To open the slide master, we have to go on view, and here we will in master views we have slide master view. Slide master basically is a template which automatically stores your information, that whatever style or whatever designing you want to do for the all the slide, you can do it in master slide. This is the concept of master slide. You have to create one master slide and then that particular format will be applied to all. Whatever you make another slide, that whatever you have designed in slide master will be get to each and every slide. First slide, then we have to open the slide master. The slide master, you will by default you will get all the tab, all the slides already built in, as they all are template slides. Now here you will get a slide at title. You can edit the master title style here, and in the body you will design here on the bottom. So here you can design title and body. For body, you can have in slide master, you will see at the top when you will select the slide master, a slide master tab is there. So already when you select the slide master, it will automatically comes slide master to edit the slide master slide. Then to edit this slide, what you can do, you can have the different themes in edit theme option. When you will click on theme drop down arrow, you will see the different themes are here, and you can select any of one of them for your slide master slide. When you will select this, it will automatically select it to all. So once you will select, and it will be applied to all. Then if you want to change the colors, then you have the colors option. You will click on here and the drop down box, and the different colors will appear, and you can change according to your need or according to your like, whatever you like. And then you have the fonts. That is the important except to change the fonts, where you have to write and how to write. You can change it from here, the style of the font, and it will change. So the font is changed at that, whatever you will write, that will come in that particular font. From the slide master only you can select all these things, and you can select the effect also, whatever effect you want to put in your slide for the data. Then you have background style here. To change the background, you will click on the background style, and you will see the different styles are there to change the background. So this, when you will apply this, and that will be applied to your slide master. But remember one thing, all these, whatever you will do the designing in slide master is only for the designing part. This all is for the designing only. To work upon, to write something, what you have to do, you go in view and move to the normal view, and then here you will get the slides by default whatever you have selected from the slide master, whatever you have designed in slide master, it will apply to all. Like this you have to work on slide master. Now in normal view, when you will do this, and in a slide master view, one more thing is there. When you move to the slide master tab, you have placeholder. You can click on the drop down box and you can see you can place the holder for content, text, picture, chart, table, smart art, media, clip art. Whatever you want to add in your slide, you can select that option. Like suppose if you want to add some text, you can have a text placeholder. If you want to add picture, you can click on picture, it will add the picture. Then chart, if you want to add the chart. If you want to add the table, you can click on the table option and the table will be added. Then you have the smart art option. Click on the smart art, you can add the smart art. If you want to add some media, you want a media box, by clicking on it your audio or video will play. So you can add that media option in your slide, and then the clip art also. You can use the clip art. So these are the options which we can have from in slide master. And in normal views, you can see here in normal views, we have a design tab. In design tab, you have so many themes. And if you will see, if you will do a right click on any of the particular theme, you will get the different option. The first one is apply to all slide. If you will click on apply to all slide, this theme will be applied to each and every slide. Then you have applied to selected slides. Then it is up to the user, you can apply it to the selected files also. Then set as default theme, you can set it as a default theme. And then add to quick access toolbar, you can add it to the gallery of the quick access toolbar. So if you want to apply to the all slide, you can click here and it will be applied to each and every slide. Now if you want to change the background style, then here in the design tab only, in design tab you have a background style option on the right hand side. You will click there and you will see different background styles are there, and you can select any of them. And the format background, you will have the different options. You can have the color option here, you can do the fill color, or you can have the gradient field, picture or texture, it is up to the you can use this texture. So many textures are available in PPTs. You can insert the file or from the clipboard, or you can have the clip art also. You can add the clip art or any file which you want. All these you can do in the background style in the design tab. These all are there for your formatting the slide. For suppose if you want to format a shape, to that for you have to go in insert and you have to add a shape. Suppose you are adding a shape here, you have added a one shape. For this shape, in home tab you have shape fill option at the right hand side. On the top you have shape fill option. In shape fill, you will click on the drop down arrow. Different colors you can select from here. So select any of the color as per your choice. It is from the home tab and the shape fill option. In save fill option only, you will get the texture option also. If you want to add some texture, you can add the texture in your shape. Like you have added the texture, you can add the texture in background. Similarly, you can add the texture in your shape, and even you can add the gradient and or any of the picture. It is totally up to you how you can use the, how you have to edit your shape. So all these come under the effect or your formatting. So this is how you can organize your slide, and you can format your slide in a different ways and in a good to look more effective and beautiful. Now if you want to add some data, in home tab to writing the data, you have the formatting the fonts option. Here you can apply the formatting effects on your font. That means on your text writing, text bold, italics, underline, all are there, and underline is also there. From the drop down arrow here in the font box, you can see there are the different font which MS PowerPoint provides you. So choose any of the font as per your choice, and you, whatever you will write, that will come under that particular font. So in the home tab you have the increment and for the decrement also. If you want to increase the size, here you have the size chart from 8 to different size chart is there. Any of the size you can choose it, and by these are the by default, these are till here is till 96, but you can write here if you want the text bigger than 96, you can write down here in the size chart and it will automatically increase the size according to your written number. From here you can have the alignment in paragraph. You can see you have the alignment. This is by default on the left hand alignment. You can choose it to the middle alignment and to the right or the starting. So any of the alignment you can choose from here. These are the justify alignment, left alignment, right alignment, and center alignment. After choosing the alignment, you have the indent option. In indent option, you can change from where you want to start this line. So from the indent, you can have the data according to your requirement. You can change the place of your data by the indent. These are the grid lines. From here you can move your data wherever you want. So this is there to organize the data in your slide. In design tab only you have the option for colors. You can change the colors by clicking here, and in color option you in a design tab like we have done in the slide master tab, you can change it from here also. You can change any of the color according to your need. So this is how you can change the color in your design tab. If you want to add a new slide, in home tab you have a new slide option. You will click here and a drop down arrow will come, and in this you can have any of the design for the new slide. You can click here and in this title and content, if you want to add a table, in the very first view, you will see here in the middle, the insert table is there. When you will click on the insert table in the middle here, you will get the number of columns and number of rows. You can increase the number of rows and increase the number of columns from here. And when you will click OK, you will see a table is there. You can make the table by here in title and content view. So here this is this, by clicking on this you can have a table. If you want to put a chart in insert option only, you will have the chart option here. You can click on the chart and the different chart will be there, and you can select any of the chart as per your need requirement, and you will click OK and the chart will be there for this particular Excel sheet. The Excel sheet is there and where the data is written, and the chart will be there in your PowerPoint. So whatever data you will change in Excel sheet, it will reflect on your chart. There are the different chart, and the most commonly used chart types are column chart, bar chart, line chart and pie chart. So these are the some common used chart type. And if you want to print your, if you want to edit, format your chart, you can right click and change the chart type, edit data and format plot area. By doing the right click you can format it. You can, if you want to format the legend, do the right click there. Wherever you want to edit, you have to do the right click there and format the chart area. You will have the edit option, format option for it. You can format it. And if you want to print the slide, go on the file option. In file option you have a print, click on print, and whatever the printer will be attached, click on the print and the slide will be printed. So this is all. If you want to exit this, you can click on exit button and it will be exited. So that's all for this revision. And please go and watch the previous videos. Thank you.